I'm sure you've wondered where I've been lately, and I can't wait to tell you. I actually took my son to Costa Rica on an amazing yoga retreat, and I'm creating an affordable and outstanding Living Fresh Insiders Club that I'll talk about maybe in a week or so. And what I've been up to is now I'm an official 200-hour certified yoga teacher through the amazing Yoga Joint training program. So I'm pretty mentally exhausted from it all, yet I'm really sad that it's over because I met some really cool people and I got to hang out with them every day. Most of the program was centered around alignment and sequencing and cueing, and it's amazing to see how many poses I was actually doing half-assed or wrong. So for example, like when you're in Warrior One pose, you know, you're not just putting your arms up and lunging. You know, you're pushing into the outer edge of the back foot. You're reaching your arms by your ears. Your hips are square. Your core is engaged. You're looking up. You know, that's a lot to think about. But there's so many cues, and that's what good yoga teachers are for, right? They tell you what to do so you don't even have to think about it. And I know a lot of you probably already have a yoga practice, but even more of you don't. So I thought I would share my top 5 reasons to try yoga. So number one, yoga is meditation. It's actually a moving meditation. There are so many benefits to yoga. It improves meditation, even in general, improves sleep, lowers stress, improves anxiety. But you know what? Few people take the time to actually meditate or feel like they can meditate. And yoga is great for the busy person because it's a moving meditation. And while you're moving, you're focusing on your breath, your form, your balance, and you're also getting all of those benefits. You know, you're not thinking about your to-dos or all those thoughts that come in your head. And not only that, but the deep breathing really helps super oxygenate your body, and it has this enormous calming effect. So number two, yoga makes you better at other sports and workouts. It's actually such a great practice because it can improve any activity you already do. So just think, more flexibility and balance means deeper squats at the gym, better form, better balance at surfing, better golfing form, and whatever you do, yoga is going to make you better at it. Number three, yoga makes you better at you. It enhances your mind-body connection. And that's so important because focusing on our breath and our body and our balance and our movements, we are forced to connect with ourselves. And so it gives us this opportunity to slow down and get more in touch with ourselves. And so many things take us away from ourselves. Yoga brings us back in to focus inside. You know, like maybe every time you eat something, you don't notice how bad you feel, but after yoga, you'll start to connect like, wow, this doesn't make me feel too good, right? So it can really help make us aware of some of these things that, you know, maybe is not so good for us, and we can change that. So yoga is also anti-aging, number four. You know how people start to lose height and they start to get like all bent over as they get older? Well, yoga helps keep our posture strong and it increases the blood flow to our body, so it has anti-aging benefits. And, you know, twists are very detoxifying. Forward bends are very calming, and that's great for our adrenal system. So it can really enhance any kind of nutritional program that you're on or any kind of benefit you want to get. Number five, yoga is for everyone, right? And some people think yoga is boring or it doesn't align with their religion, and that's all boring, right? First of all, yoga can be fun, right, Ethan?
Yeah.
A lot of yoga classes have like chanting or slow music or different things, but now modern yoga has hip hop and pop and you name it. You know, a lot of us realize that, you know, music takes us to places that we really, you know, it helps keep us going. And so find a yoga class that jives to the beat of your drum. And you know, as far as religion, I used to feel really uncomfortable chanting Om, and I felt kind of weird, like I was participating in some other kind of religion. But thankfully, you know, after chanting in class with my students and teachers almost every single day, I started to love it. And in fact, there were times when the collective sound, it felt so powerful, I was actually moved by emotion. And trust me, you guys, saying that feels so strange, but it's 100% true. And Om is actually the sonic representation of Ishvara, which is, you know, it's basically whatever your higher power is. Om is a manifestation of whether it's Shiva, Allah, Jesus. It's the intention behind Om is entirely up to you. So yoga is not a religion, but it can be a nice complement to whatever religion you practice. And in that, each movement can become a prayer and an intention, and each breath can be done with devotion. And so, you know, I'm not saying that like every time I get on the mat, I do this, because some days, you guys, I just want to go out there and flow to The Cure or Tupac or whatever. But definitely having experienced this more devotional side of yoga makes me want to bring these peaceful intentions, you know, into my mat more regularly. So no matter where flexibility is, yoga is for you. Because it's not about how the pose looks, it's about how it feels, and it should feel so good. So instead of pushing like to get in a pose that looks really good, take your time to use the props like blocks and straps and pillows. Because the main idea, you definitely want to challenge yourself, but the main idea is you want to be in the proper alignment, which keeps your body safe, and be gentle on yourself, because every body is different and every day you're gonna feel different. And so if we honor that, where we are without judgment, and can find that place of peace, that's where the real magic happens. And that's for both on and off the mat. So I hope I've encouraged you guys to try yoga sometime soon. And if you wanna do yoga with me, I'm not teaching a class right now, but you can always reach out and we can get a class together, or we could do a private. And that's it. So namaste, amigos. Try it.